quite difficult for me for a long time, talking to people, socializing. So just keep going forward and find people that will make time to meet with you.
What do you think you struggled most with your autism?
Quite difficult for me for a long time. You know, I was afraid to get my driver's license and I didn't want to get it right away when I was still in high school. I wanted to wait until after high school. And then also, you know, talking to people, socializing, because I like to always have it be the Kenny Valdivia show, because sometimes things I'm interested in doesn't always appeal to me. And also, yeah, socializing. And that's why I had trouble making friends growing up, because people wanted nothing to do with me because I was just so arrogant. And I would just constantly babble about myself and my wants and my interests. And also, especially when it comes to talking to girls.
So in terms of like society, what do you think needs to change the most in what people think about autism, ADHD, and in general people with special needs?
I mean, since schools have a lot of the special needs classrooms, the kids should understand and take a look at how each person differs, because I was put in the special needs classrooms, but I wasn't on that part of the spectrum. I was on the higher end of the spectrum, and that's why, you know, I wanted to be in the other classrooms with the other kids, because I just didn't fit in there.
All right, so what do you think needs to change in like the representation in the media?
They just should let people get the chance to express themselves, and that's the whole point of YouTube, is giving everybody a chance to speak. And also, because I know someone in their 60s, because he grew up in a very different time. When he was born in the middle of the 1950s, growing up in 1960s, 70s, and 80s, autism was not known back then. People did not know what it was. And he really had a hard childhood, and he suffered a lot of traumas. And especially when he had jobs, he was fired so many times because he just made a lot of mistakes, and he was just very loud, and the employers didn't care about his disability.
What do you think has changed the most in the last 20 years in terms of society and media, in terms of autism, special needs, and ADHD?
There are more doctors out there that, you know, give treatment for it. A lot of, you know, therapists and psychologists that help people with their speech developments, and also the special education classes. And yeah, especially with the YouTube and Facebook and whatnot, it really helps people understand it better.
What do you think has changed the most in your life in like the last 5 years?
I've always been a very outgoing person, but now more than ever, I'm just very outgoing, and I'm just eager to meet connections and, you know, put the bond with some people that I admire. And I just like to meet accomplished autistic individuals. And I'm glad, like, when I hear a story on the news, it always gets me going. It's like, I want to meet that person. I want to meet that person. For example, I want to give a shout out to Haley Moss. She became the first employed lawyer out of Florida that has autism.
What do you think needs to change the most in like the next 5 to 10 years?
Just give people a chance. They should just give them a chance and, you know, not jump to conclusions, because people with autism are very gifted. And I don't think it's a disease. There's so many people that are just so down upon themselves. Case in point, you know, Jonathan Mitchell, I've always, you know, tried to help him out the best I could, but, and he's always saying that he wishes that there was a cure for autism, but I don't think there it's necessary. Autism is very unique and it's different. You know, it's what makes people stand out, especially myself.
Do you have any advice for people with autism or special needs in general?
Yes. I mean, it can be very difficult growing up, for sure. It was difficult for me making friends, but You know, find people that will support you. Don't pay attention to the haters, the naysayers. Don't give them any credit any time of the day. So just keep going forward and find people that will make time to meet with you. And, you know, it's taken me a while, but I feel like some of the best friends I have are other people that have autism and other special needs. You know, they really inspire me to keep going. And, you know, I like to share their testimonies as well, because they're very powerful people as well. And autism is not a mistake.
I definitely agree. So you have a lot of friends with autism?
Oh, yes. I have my friends, for example, a lot of them I share on YouTube, like EJ Tan and Jacob Olson. I've been good friends with them for about, you know, yeah, 5-6 years. And Marshall Weeks, Tony Saturno, I met them, most of them, you know, at Exceptional Minds, where I was going for art and graphic design. But long story short, I didn't want to do art and graphic design anymore. But even then, you know, there's some of the few people I've kept in touch with through the years, and we have a lot of common interests and, yeah, difficulty socializing, which is what made us bond together. You know, since we have difficulty socializing with the general public, you know, that's where we can come together and socialize with amongst each other to better improve our socialization skills.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you, sir.